بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه ما بعد. In this year, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to answer a request to summarize the chapter of Bab Waqf Hamzah wa Hishamin ala al-Hamz. When it comes to this chapter, the best way to conceptualize it is to divide it into four parts. Divide the chapter into four sections. The first section, Hamzah Sakina, preceded by a Mutaharrik. Title it as Section 1, Hamzah Sakina, preceded by a Mutaharrik. Hamzah Sakina, qablaha Mutaharrik. That's Section 1. Section 2 will be Hamzah Mutaharrika, qablaha Sakin. Hamzah Mutaharrika, preceded by a Sakin. Section 3 will be Hamzah Mutaharrika, qablaha Mutaharrik. Hamzah Mutaharrika, qablaha Mutaharrik. Hamzah Mutaharrika, preceded by a Mutaharrik. And then Section 4, Miscellaneous Principles. Miscellaneous Principles. When it comes to Section 1, we titled it as Hamzah Sakina preceded by a Mutaharrik. What falls under this section are 2 points. What falls under this section are 2 points. When it comes to this Hamzah, we said it's Hamzah Sakina. Therefore, this Sukun can either be what? Asli or Arif, right? This Hamzah can either be Asli or Arif. Right, either a primary sukun, meaning an original sukun, this hamza had the sukun aslan, or it's a temporary sukun, meaning it only came about due to al-waqf. طيب. And so we have section 1, hamza sakina preceded by a mutaharrik. Now this hamza sakina can either be asliya, or it could be what? Arida. If it's asliya, for example, ya'kulun, for example, ta'khudunahu, for example, iqra', for example, nabbi', for example, شِئْتُمَا, for example, أَنُؤْمِنُ لَكَ, for example, أَلْمُؤْمِنُونَ, right? For example, جِئْتَ, طيب. For example, إِن يَشَأْ, طيب. Doesn't matter whether it occurs in the middle or the ending of the word. طيب. So that's the first case under Section 1. Hamzah Sakina, preceded by Mutaharrik, and this Hamzah Sakina is Asliya. The ruling here is going to be what? الْإِبْدَال, الْإِبْدَال. So you're going to do إِبْدَال of the Hamza to a Mad letter. Now this Mad letter is linked to the vowel that's on the letter that precedes the Hamza, right? And so for example, in Ya'kulun, the Hamza Sakin is preceded by Ya' Maftuha, and so we're going to convert this Hamza into a Alif. Why? Because what precedes it is a Fatha, and Fatha and Alif are linked together. And the evidence for this in the Shatibiyya is what? فَأَبْدِلْهُ عَنْهُ حَرْفَ مَدٍ مُسَكِّنًا وَمِن قَبْلِهِ تَحْرِيكُهُ قَدْ تَنَزَّلَ. Okay. So that's section 1, we have Hamza Sakina preceded by a Mutaharrik. We said under this, we have the Sakin being Asli. We said the example, Ya'kulu, Yasha', Iqra', Ma'mana, Bi'r, Bi's, Jita, so on. The ruling is al-Ibdal, Ibdal of the Hamza into a Mad letter. Now this Mad letter must be linked to the vowel on the preceding letter, or on the letter that precedes the Hamza. So مثلا, in Jita, it will become what? Jita. So the Kasra is linked to the Ya', the Dhamma is linked to the Waw, and the Hamza is linked to the Fatha, which should be known already. Now, the second point is that the Hamza has a Sukun which is Arid. So the Sukun here is temporary. Tayyib, and this important point is that it can only occur at the end of the word. So when it comes to the Sukun Asli, it can occur in the middle or the end. When it comes to the Sukun Arid, the Arid can only occur at the end of the word. For example, An-Naba'i. An-Naba'i al-Azim. Right? Had al-Waqf, it becomes An-Naba'. So this Hamza originally had a kasra, if you were to conjoin it, but because you stopped on it, the sukun came, right? For example, min shalti il wadi halwaf min shalti, right? Yun shi'u becomes yun shi', hama'in becomes hama', right? Inimru'un becomes inimru', طيب. And so what's the hukum here? The hukum here is again al-ibdal, ibdal to a mad letter, which is linked, of course, to the vowel on the preceding letter, on the letter that precedes the hamza. And the evidence is the same evidence we mentioned before. فَأَبْدِلْهُ عَنْهُ حَرْفَ مَدٍ مُسَكِينًا وَمِنْ قَبْلِهِ تَحْرِيكُهُ قَدْ تَنَزَّلَ. However, when it comes to this sukun عَارَض, we have a second wajah, right? Which is تسهيل with روم. التسهيل بالروم. As الشاطبي mentioned, وَمَا قَبْلَهُ التَّحْرِيكُ أَوْ أَلِفٌ مُحَرْ وَكَمْ طَرَفًا فَالْبَعْضُ بِالرَّوْمِ سَهَلَا. طيب. And of course, this is only applicable on condition that the initial haraka on this hamza, meaning before we stopped on it, right, there was a haraka on it. This haraka must be, of course, either a kasra or a dhamma. Of course, it can accept raum. طيب. For example, yunshi. We can say what? ibdal yunshi, right? Or we can say what at tasil ibram yunshihu, right? Of course, in this case, the haraka on the on yunshi, when we're conjoining it with what comes after, it'll be a dhamma yunshi'u, right? So hal al waqf becomes yunshi, and so we can have two awjuh here: wajh al ibdal yunshi, and wajh al thani wajh al tasil ibram yunshi'u. طيب. Nah. So that's the first section completed. So the first section is a hamza sakinah preceded by a mutaharrik. This sakin can be either asli or arad. If it's asli, then ibdal. It doesn't matter whether it's in the middle or the end. Of course, yani we should know that Hisham only has what? A tatarruf, right? The mutatarrif hamza, in which he only does what? Taghir, right? We know the hamza, he does it whether it's in the middle or the end, as we've taken before. طيب. And so that should be well known. طيب. As a shatibi mentioned, وحمزة عند الوقف سهل همزه إذا كان وسطا أو تطرف منزلا. And he mentioned for Hisham في غير هذا بين بين مثله يقول هشام ما تطرف مسهلا أي مغير. طيب. And so Hisham only changes the همزة when it occurs at the end of the word. But Hamza does it whether it's in the middle or at the end. طيب. So we have this first section done and dusted now. طيب. همزة ساكنة preceded by متحرك can be of two types. ساكن أصلي ساكن عارض. If it's ساكن أصلي it can be in the middle or at the end. Of course, for Hamza, it doesn't matter whether it's in the middle or the end, he will change it. But Hisham only changes it if it's at the end. And the changing here is going to be ibdal to a mid letter. And this mid letter is linked to the vowel that occurs on the letter that precedes the Hamza. And the evidence for that is فَأَبْدِلْهُ عَنْهُ حَرْفَ مَدٍ مُسَكِّنًا وَمِنْ قَبْلِهِ تَحْرِيكُهُ قَدْ تَنَزَّلَ. If the sukun is arad, the sukun upon Hamza is sukun arad. And this can only occur, we mentioned, at the ending of the word. For example, النَّبَئِ right, حَمَئٍ مِنْ مَلْجَئٍ يُنْشِئُ إِنِمْغُؤٌ طيب. Then here we have two ways of reading it. The first way is al-ibdal to a mid letter that is linked to the vowel or on the letter that precedes the hamza, right? And that's the evidence فَأَبْدِلُ عَنْهُ حَرْفَ مَدٍ مُسَكِّنًا وَمِنْ قَبْلِهِ تَحْرِيكُهُ قَدْ تَنَزَّلَ. And we also have the second wajh, which is وَجْهُ التَّسْهِيلِ بِالرَّوْمِ وَجْهُ التَّسْهِيلِ بِالرَّوْمِ as the الشَّاطِبِ mentioned وَمَنْ قَبْلَهُ التَّحْرِيكُ أَوْ أَلِفٌ مُحَرَّكًا طَرَفًا فَالْبَعْضُ بِالرَّوْمِ سَهَلَ. Of course, on condition that the haraka that was on the hamza initially accepts rom. It's either a kasra or a dhamma. Na'am. Then we have the second section in which we said hamza mutaharrika qablaha sakin. Hamza mutaharrika preceded by a sakin. Now this sakin can be one of five. This sakin can be one of five. So 5 points fall under the second section. The first type is sakin sahih. A sakin which is what? Sahih. طيب. For example, مثلاً you have Al-Qur'an. So you have here the Hamza is preceded by a Ra, which is the Sakin, which is Sahih. طيب. Meaning, when we say Sahih, it's not Mu'tal. So the Sakin that precedes it, it's not Mu'tal. And we should know what Sahih and Mu'tal is. We've taken it in Ilm Al-Sarf. طيب. And in summary, essentially, it's not a Waw Alif O. Oh yeah, so what precedes the Hamza, it's not a Waw Alif O. Oh yeah. So in this case, Al-Qur'an. طيب. For example, Mil'u. Mil'u. حال الوقف Mil'u. And the lamb here has Sakin Sahih. طيب. What's the ruling? The ruling is النقل. نقل حركة الهمزة إلى الساكن قبلها مع حذف الهمزة. Right? As الشاطبي mentioned, وحرك به ما قبله متسكنا وأسقطه حتى يرجع اللفظ أسهلا. طيب. وأسقطه حتى يرجع اللفظ أسهلا. And so if the همزة متحركة is preceded by a ساكن صحيح, the ruling is النقل. النقل مع الحذف. طيب. And of course, the إشمام and the روم applies if, of course, the حركة upon the همزة which has been transferred to the ساكن صحيح which preceded it, and then we removed the همزة. If this حركة is a كسرة أي ضمة, then of course you can apply إشمام. And Rome, of course, if it's a kasra, you can apply Rome, and if it's Ishmam, you can apply both. If it's a kasra, you can apply Rome, and if it's a dhamma, you can apply Ishmam and Rome. So, for example, mil'u al-ardi, right? If you stop on the word mil'u, the hamza has a dhamma. You're putting that dhamma on the lam. So, naql harakat al-hamza ila al-sakin qablaha ma'a al-hadf. Right? So, it becomes what? Mil'u. Of course, har al-waqf, you say mil, طيب. And of course, here you can come into, because it's a dhamma, you can apply Ishmam or طيب. So that's the ساكن صحيح. For another example could be المرئي, right? المرئي وزوجه المرئي حال الوقف it becomes المر. طيب. And of course you can apply here the روم only. You can't apply إشمام, only applies upon the ضمه, right? You can apply روم here, but you can't apply إشمام. طيب. I remember يعني إشمام and روم, it's something which is not necessary. It's not the first wajah. It's like مثلاً when you're reciting for حفص إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين, you can say that, and you can also say يستعين, right? You can do إسمام and رون, and you can also do إسكان محض. And of course, the primary wajah is وجه الإسكان, right? And so when you're doing here نقل مع الحذف, you come with مع الإسكان المحض. And then, of course, if it's allowed to do روم and إشمام, you can do روم and إشمام. طيب, so don't focus on the روم and إشمام too much. Just focus on the main وجه. طيب. Of course, if in the middle of the Quran or in the middle of the word, there won't be any إشمام or روم because you know إشمام or روم only occurs at the end of a word. Now, example of the middle will be what Al-Quran. And so, حال الوقف, we say what Al-Quran for Hamza. Now, so that's the first type. Remember, we said section two, Hamza متحركة preceded by a ساكن. And so, it's Hamza the حركة. And it's preceded by a sakin. This sakin is of five types. The first type is sakin sahih. We've mentioned the ruling for it and the evidence. The second one is a waw or ya maddiyah or lean. And this waw or ya is asli. It's asli. Right? For example, as-saw, shay'a, kahay'a, al-musi'u, tabu'a. So the waw here is maddiyah, meaning it's a waw sakinah preceded by a madmun. Or a ya' maddiyah, ya' sakinah preceded by a maksur. Or it's a ya' or waw lean asli, meaning asli that's part and parcel of the word a'iz, min binyat al-kalimah. It's min binyat al-kalimah. طيب, shay' ala wazni, fa'al. And so the ya' here, or the hamza here I should say, and before it the waw ya' maddiyah, or the ya' waw ya' lean in this case, it's what? It's min binyat al-kalimah. It's min binyat al-kalimah. It's from the building blocks of the letter of the word, I should say. طيب, شيء على وزن فعل. Of course, we know the building block of a verb or of a word is the فعل كلمة, عين كلمة, لام الكلمة, right? And everything else it will be a زائدة. So we have here the ياء, a lean in this case. It's in the same level as the عين الكلمة. And so we say it's أصلي. And so the واو ياء مد or the واو ياء lean أصلي. This is second section. It's second. Point, the second type of sakin. طيب, so remember section 2, Hamza متحركة preceded by a sakin, right? The second is of five types. The first type is sakin sahih. The second type is a waw ya maddiyah or a waw ya lean asli. What is the ruling? The ruling here is al-naql ma' al-hadf, right? As al-Shati mentioned, in the same evidence, وحرك به ما قبله متسكنا وأسقطه حتى يرجع اللفظ أسهلا. طيب, that's the first wajah. You also have a second wajah, which is وجه الإبدال مع الإدغام. وجه الإبدال مع الإدغام. And so you can say مثلا السوء. You can say النقل مع الحذف. And so it becomes what? السوء. السوء. طيب. And of course here, because the حركة, the initial حركة was a كسرة, you can apply الروم as well. طيب. You can also apply the second وجه, which will be what? وجه الإبدال مع الإدغام. وجه الإبدال مع الإدغام. Right? And has to say what? السوء. السوء. طيب. إبدال. So of the Hamza into a waw. And of course here now you have a waw sakin followed by a waw maksur. Right? And so you have here idgham saghir which takes place. And بحيث يصيراني حرفا واحدا مشددا. And so it becomes what? السوي. And of course حال الوقف, you get rid of the waw. You get rid of the kasra, sorry. And so it becomes what? السو. وحاذر الوقف بكل الحركة. إلا إذا رمت فبعض حركة. إلا بفتح نور بنصب وأشم إشارة برفع في ضم في رفع وضم. طيب. And so here we can say السو إدغام مع إبدال مع إدغام مع السكون المحض. And also we can also come with وجه الروم. Why? Because the initial حركة was a كسرة. طيب. So this is the second point, which is the type of سكون واو ياء مدية or واو ياء لين أصلي. The ruling is النقل مع الحذف. And the second وجه is الإبدال مع الإدغام. نعم. And الروم and الإشمام apply where applicable. The third type of sukun in under section 2 is the waw ya mad lin zaida. So the waw ya madiya or the waw ya li zaida zaida. طيب, zaida of course means that it does not fall as part of the original word, meaning it's not fa al kalima or ain al kalima or lam al kalima. طيب, for example hani'an, the asl is hana'a. Hana'a was the ya, it's not present. The ya is zaida. The ya is an additional letter. طيب, it's not part of the building blocks of the word. And so when it comes to the waw or ya maddiyah or waw ya lin zaida, the ruling here is only al ibdal ma al idgham. Only ibdal ma al idgham. There is no naql. There is no naql. For example, quru'. Quru'. The asr is qur'. Qur'. So the waw here is zaida. طيب. And so we say the waw here when we are reciting قروء حال الوقف حمزة و هشام in this case, we recite with what? الإبدال مع الإدغام قروء. And of course, the ثلاثة قروء in. The Hamza had a كسر on it, so we can apply وجه الروم as well in this special scenario. And of course, إشمام الروم apply where applicable. And we mentioned where it's applicable earlier. طيب, so we don't have to repeat it over and over again. And the evidence for this, of course, ويدغم فيه الواو والياء مبدلا إذا زيرتها من قبل حتى يفصلا. ويدغم فيه الواو والياء مبدلا إذا زيرتها من قبل حتى يفصلا. نعم. So that's the third type. The fourth type of sukun under section 2 is an alif maddiyah, and this is in the middle of the word, like al-malaika. An alif maddiyah in the middle of the word. And so what's the ruling here? The ruling here will be tasheel bayna bayna. التسهيل بين بين. Of course, مع المد والقصر. وإن حرف مد قبل همز مغير يجوز قصره والمد ما زال عدلا. Right, and so here we can have the alif maddiyah. When it occurs in the middle of فحمزة حال الوقف, you have the تسهيل بين بين six counts or two counts. And the evidence, سوى أنه من بعد ما ألف جرى يسهله مهما توسط مدخلا. Right, سوى أنه من بعد ما ألف جرى يسهله مهما توسط مدخلا. And so the alif mad, when it occurs in the middle of the word and it is a sakin that precedes a hamza mutahrika, then we apply وجه التسهيل بين بين. And so الملائكة becomes الملائكة الملائكة. We then have the fifth type of sakin, which is an alif maddiyah, and the hamza is occurring at the end of the word, meaning the last two letters of the word are a hamza, which is the last letter, and it's preceded by an alif maddiyah. Here, we can divide this section into three subsections. So remember, we have the overarching section 2, which is a hamza mutaharrika preceded by a sakin. This sakin is of five types. Sakin sahih, waw ya mad lin asli, waw o ya mad o slash lin zaida, alif mad, which occurs in the middle of the word. And now I have the fifth type, an alif mad, with the hamza occurring at the end of the word. We can divide this fifth section into three subtypes. The first subtype is if the hamza has a fatha. If the hamza is maftuh. If the hamza is maftuh, we have three ways of stopping on it for hamza. And that is al-ibdal. Al-ibdalu ma'a al-qasr. Wal-ibdalu ma'a al-tawassut. Wal-ibdalu ma'a al-tul. And the evidence for this is وَيُبْدِلُهُ مَهْمَا تَطَرَّفَ مِثْلَهُ وَيَقْصُرُ أَوْ يَمْضِي عَلَى الْمَدِّ أَطْوَلَا. For example, جَاءَ. If you want to stop on it, say جَاءَ. جَاءَ. So ibdal of the hamza, the ibdal of the hamza al-maftuha with al-qasr and with al-tawassud and with al-tul of the alif that comes before it. And so it becomes what? Ja, ja, ja. طيب. That's the first subtype under the fifth point, right? Or the fifth type of sukun. The second one is if the hamza has a dhammah or a kasra and it's not been written with a waw or a ya. Remember that when it comes to the Rasm al-Uthmani, the Hamza can be written either with a Ya, or with a Waw, or with an Alif, or ala al-Satr, on the line, meaning without an image. Because remember, the one who put the image for Hamza was Khalid ibn Ahmed al-Farahidi, who came around 100 or so years after the Uthmani script. طيب. And so, when it comes to the second type that we're speaking about, which is we have a hamza and it has a dhamma and it has a kasra or it has a kasra and it's not been written with either a waw or a ya. So this hamza has not been written with a waw or a ya, but it has a dhamma or a kasra. What do? Here we have five ways of reading it. We have five ways of reading, and we call it khamsat al-qiyas. We call it khamsat al-qiyas. They are the first three ways we mentioned for type number one. So the ibdal ma'al qasr, ibdal ma'al tawassut, ibdal ma'al ishba', right? And then we add on to it التسهيل بالروم مع المد والقصر. التسهيل بالروم مع المد والقصر. And the evidence is ويبدله مهما تطرف مثله ويقصر أو يمضي على المد أطول. And for the تسهيل بالروم مع المد والقصر, قوله رحمه الله وما قبله التحريك أو ألف محار ركا طرفا فالبعض بالروم سهلا. And so السفهاء. السفهاء. Here, when you look at the Rasm al-Uthmani, the Hamza is not written with a waw or a ya, but it has a dhamma. And so we recite it with these five ways. ثلاثة الإبدال السفهاء السفهاء السفهاء. And then التسهيل بالروم مع المد والتسهيل بالروم مع القصر السفهاء السفهاء. طيب. Then we have the third and final subtype that falls under this fifth point, right? Which is if the Hamza has a Dhamma and it's written with a Waw, or if the Hamza has a Kasra and it's written with a Ya. If the Hamza has a Dhamma and it's written with a Waw, then we have 12 ways of reading it. خمسة القياس and سبعة الرسم. خمسة القياس and سبعة الرسم. And when it comes to the Hamza having a Kasra and being written with a Ya, then we say we have خمسة القياس and أربعة الرسم, meaning we have 9 أوجه in total. So let's take the first point. The Hamza has a Dhamma and it's written with a Waw. We said 12 ways of reading, and they are خمسة القياس that we mentioned in the second point, right? مع سبعة الرسم, along with سبعة الرسم. And this is المذهب الرسمي. Right, so we have مذهب القياسي, خمسة القياس, and we have سبعة الرسم. قال الشاطبي رحمه الله وقد رأوا أنه بالخط كان مسهلا ففي اليا يلي والواو والحذف رسمه. And of course, remember we said that the rasmi, it's not something which is what? قاعدة مضطردة, meaning it's not something which is found, or it's not a principle which is applied throughout the Quran. Rather, it's applied in special مواضع in the Quran al-Kareem. Right, so by consensus, you find it in a few مواضع in the Quran, and عبد الفتاح القاضي compiled them in his شرح on الشاطبية الوافي في شرح الشاطبية. Right, and so we find the first مواضع in Surah Al-An'am, فيكم شركاء. So here شركاء, if we were to go to the مصحف, you find it's written, the Hamza is written with a Waw. The Hamza is written with a Waw, and so we stop on it with what? With these 12 ways, with these 12 ways. خمسة القياس and سبعة الرسم. وراء سبعة الرسم, سبعة الرسم is إبدال الهمزة واوا ساكنة مع المد والتوسط والقصر. وإبدال الهمزة واوا مع الإشمام والمد والتوسط والقصر. وإبدال الهمزة واوا مع الروم بالقصر فقط, أو بالروم مع القصر فقط. طيب, so we have the seven أوجه. إبدال الهمزة into a واو ساكنة along with مد توسط القصر. إبدال الهمزة into a واو مع الإشمام with مد توسط القصر. And إبدال the همزة to a واو with روم but just only قصر. That's seven أوجه combined with the five القياس gives you 12 الرسم. And so the مواضع in the Quran by consensus in which you apply these 12 أوجه فيكم شركاء لقد تقطع بينكم من سورة الأنعام, أم لهم شركاء وشرعوا لهم من الدين سورة الشورى, في أموالنا ما نشاء إنك لأنت حليم ورشيد سورة هود. Right, فقال الضعفاء للذين استكبروا من سورة إبراهيم, شفعاء وكانوا شركاء كافرين سورة الروم. Right, لهو البلاء المبين سورة الصافات, وما دعاء الكافرين إلا في ضلال سورة غافر, وما دعاء الكافرين سورة غافر, بلاء مبين سورة الدخان. Right, إنا براء منكم من سورة الامتحان سورة الممتحنة, جزاء الظالمين إنما جزاء إن سورة إنما جزاء الذين يحاربون الله سورة المائدة. Right, and also وجزاء سيئة سيئة مثلها إن سورة الشورى. Right, and likewise جزاء الظالمين إن سورة الحشر. And if you go back to the Al-Wafi في شرح الشاطبي, you'll find these points mentioned, or these special مواضع where we apply these أوجه for حمزة. And of course, Hisham, Hala, Al-Waqf. These 12 awjuh, these are the places in which we do. Of course, there are some mawadi' in which there is khilaf as well, in that the rasm, has it come with the waw or not? And they are, مثلا, جزاو من تزكى in Surah Taha, جزاو المحسنين in Surah Az-Zumar, وكذا, in likewise, جزاو الحسنى in Surah Al-Kahf, right? For Hisham specifically, right? So جزاو الحسنى here, Surah Al-Kahf, Hisham has khilaf. Likewise, علماء وبني إسرائيل in Surah Al-Shu'ara, likewise إنما يخشى الله من بعد العلماء إن سورة فاطر. Right, likewise أنباء ما كانوا به يستهزئون in both سورة الأنعام and الشعراء. And عبد الفتاح القاضي mentioned those points in detail. طيب, where we apply this مذهب الرسمي. Right, and these 12 يعني خمسة القياس مع سبعة الرسم. Right, in these مواضع by consensus in the مواضع mentioned and some مواضع with خلاف. And as for if the Hamza has a Kasra and it's written with a Ya, then as you mentioned, there are 9 ways of reading it. خمسة القياس مع أربعة الرسم. And why do we say أربعة الرسم? We get rid of the وجه الإشمام. Remember, if it's a Kasra, there is no إشمام. Remember, إشمام only occurs upon the Dhamma. Now, and of course, again, عبد الفتاح القاضي mentioned these special مواضع in which we apply this مذهب الرسمي من تلقاء نفسي مثلا وإيتاء ذي القربى ومن آناء الليل سورة طه right من وراء حجاب سورة الشورى right likewise بلقاء ربهم بخلاف right ولقاء الآخرة سورة الروم these are يعني مختلف فيه طيب مختلف فيهما طيب that's the second section now completed so the second section we had the Hamzah متحركة preceded by a ساكن. The ساكن is of five types. ساكن صحيح. The ياء مد slash لين أصلي. The واو أو ياء مد slash لين زائدة. That's the third one. The ألف مد in the middle of the word. Or the ألف مد with the همزة occurring at the end of the word. Which divides into three further types. همزة having a فتحة. Three ways of reading only. ثلاث البدل. ثلاث البدل I should say. If the همزة has a ضمة or a كسرة. But it's not been written with a واو أو ياء. خمسة القياس. And if the همزة has a ضمة. And it's been written with a واو. خمسة القياس مع سبعة الرسم and if the Hamza has been written with a ya sorry if the Hamza has a كسرة and it's been written with a ya then we say خمسة القياس مع أربعة الرسم طيب we then have section 3 which is the Hamza متحركة preceded by متحرك so we have here Hamza which is متحركة preceded by متحرك nine possible combinations Hamza having a فتحة and being preceded by a كسرة for example خاطئة ناشئة مئة طيب or the Hamza having a فتحة being preceded by مظلوم for example يؤخر right لؤلؤا so لؤلؤا the second one right likewise مؤذن يؤيد in these two cases we convert the Hamza to a ياء and a واو إبدال right قال الشاطبي رحمه الله ويسمع بعد الكسر والضم بهمزه لدى فتحه ياء وواوا محولة and so we say مية خاطية يويد مؤذن حال الوقف نعم Then we have the next section, which is five further cases. So remember, we said there are nine in total. We've taken two, seven remain. Let's take five out of these seven. And that is the Hamza being مفتوحة, being preceded by a مفتوح. Hamza being مضمومة, being preceded by a مفتوح. Hamza being مكسورة, preceded by a مفتوح. Hamza being مضمومة, preceded by a مضموم. Hamza being مكسور, preceded by a مكسور. For example, متكئين, خاطئين. Right, برؤوسكم حينئذ مطمئنين. Right, تأزهم سأل. In all five of these cases, you recite with تسهيل بين بين. قال الشاطبي رحمه الله وفي غير هذا بين بين وفي غير هذا بين بين. What remains two more logical combinations, and that is the Hamza having a كسرة being preceded by a ضمة, and the Hamza having a ضمة being preceded by a كسرة. For example, فمالئون مستهزئون نبئوني سئلوا سئلا سئلت. Right, in these cases we have, of course, وجه التسهيل بين بين, and the evidence for that being وفي غير هذا بين بين. Then we have, of course, the special مذهب of الأخفش والأخفش بعد الكسر والضم أبدل بياء وعنه الواو في عكسه. طيب. And so, of course, in these two cases, the Hamza being maksur, being preceded by madhmum, Hamza being madhmum, being preceded by maksur, wajhan, tasheel bayna bayna, and ala madhab al-akhfash, al-ibidal. طيب, so we can say what? Wal-akhfashu ba'ad al-kasri, al-dhammi, abdala biya'in wa'anhu al-waw fi aksi, ibdal to a waw and ibdal to a ya. So, su'ilu becomes harf, su'wilu, su'wilu. طيب, of course, mustahzi'un becomes mustahzi'un, mustahzi'un. طيب, this is wajhu. على مذهب الأخفش على مذهب الأخفش and of course مستهزئون we have the وجه الحذف as well as the author الشاطبي رحمه الله تعالى mention طيب قال الشاطبي رحمه الله قال الشاطبي رحمه الله تعالى ومستهزئون الحذف فيه ونحوه وضم وكسر قبل قيل وأخملا and so we have مستهزون as well for حمزة طيب حال الوقف طيب and so this this third section which is the Hamza mutaharrika being preceded by a mutaharrik we said there are nine possible combinations the first two combinations khati'ah and yu'ayyid we have ibdal wa yusma'u ba'da al-kasri wa dhammi hamzahu wa nada fathihi ya'an wa wawan muhawwil al-hamza al-maftuha and it's being preceded by a dhamma or a kasra now we have the five cases in which we have fatha fatha like sa'ala likewise also fatha dhamma for example ra'uf وتأزهم we have also بئيس يومئذ فتح كسرة right برؤوسكم ضم ضم right and we have خاطئين كسرة كسرة in these five cases we start with والتسهيل بين بين وفي غير هذا بين بين and we have of course two special أوجه which we have the two ways of reading it تسهيل بين بين and of course إبدال على مذهب الأخفش سئلوا نبئوني مستهزئون فمالئون ليواطئوا سنقرئك سئلة سوا ضم كسرة كسرة ضم نعم And the evidence for that is وَلَخْفَشُ بَعْدَ الْكَسْرِ وَالضَّمِّ أَبْدَلَ بِيَاءٍ وَعَنْهُ الْوَاوُ فِي عَكْسِهِ إِلَى آخِرِهِ. Then we have the final section, section number 4, and these are miscellaneous points, right? These are extra points that the author mentioned. And of course, the famous one is الْمُتَوَسِّطُ بِزَائِدٍ, right? The hamza that occurs in the middle of the word due to an extra letter, meaning this letter came onto it, forcing the hamza to now go into the middle of the word when it was initially at the beginning of the word. For example, وَالسَّمَاءَ بَنَيْنَاهَا بِأَيْدٍ. Aid, that's the word, and the hamza occurs at the beginning of the word. Remember, if the hamza occurs at the beginning of the word, يَقِفُ عَلَيْهَا هَمْزَةُ بِالتَّحْقِيقَ, right? You stop on it with تَحْقِيقَ. But here, this hamza, which was initially in the beginning of the word, it's now being pushed into the middle of the word because of the presence of the ba, كَمَا هَا وَيَا وَاللَّامِ وَالْبَا وَنَحْوِهَا وَلَا مَا تَعْرِيفٍ لِمَنْ قَدْ تَأَمَّلَ, right? And so here we have for hamza, وَجْهَان, وَقْفَا. Hamza, we have wajahani, waqfa. The first wajah is a tahqiq, bi aidin. And the second wajah is treated as though the letter that forced it to become mutawassita bi zaid, treated as though it's asli. Treated as though it's asli. And so the rulings of the asli apply. For example, in bi aidin becomes what? Bi aidin. Right? Bi aidin. Because what? Hamza mutaharrika being preceded by a mutaharrika. Hamza maftuha being preceded by a maksur, and so we apply the madhab of al-ibdal. We use ba'da al-kasri wa-dhammi hamzahu lada fathihi ya'an wa'awan muhawwilan. So we say what was sama'a banaynaha biyayid biyayid halal waqf. That's the second wajah. And of course the first wajah at-tahqiq bi-ayid. Both awjuh are equally valid. Qala al-shatibi rahimahullah wa ma fihi ulfa wasitan bi-zawaidin dakhalina alayhi fihi wajhani أعمل كماها ويا واللام والباء ونحوها ولامات تعريف لمن قد تأمل. نعم. And then another miscellaneous point is, of course, when it comes to أنبئهم and نبئهم حال الوقف, you can stop on it with كسر الهاء, and likewise بضم الهاء, وبعضهم بكسر الهاء لياء تحول قولك أنبئهم ونبئهم إلى آخره. Right, so you can say أنبيهم, you can also say أنبيهم. And of course, here we have a hamza sakina being preceded by a mutaharrik, right? And it's hamza sakin asli, right? And so we recite it with al-ibdal anbihim and anbihum. Nabbihim, nabbihum. طيب. Another miscellaneous point, wari'yan ala idharihi wa idghamihi. You can recite it with al-idhar or al-idgham. Hala al-waqf. Hala al-waqf. Because remember, this hamza is hamza sakina asliya, right? It's being preceded by a kasra. And so we can say ibdal riya ha bil-idhar or riya. بالإدغام. طيب. So that's another miscellaneous point that the author mentioned. طيب. As for المستهزئون الحذف, we mentioned that وجه already. طيب. And with that, we've taken the entire chapter. I don't think there's anything left to mention. And so we can stop here بإذن الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك نعم. One more point is one more point that we can mention is the مسألة of الإشمام الروم. Right, وَأَشْمَرُمْ فِي مَا سِوَى مُتَبَدِّلٍ. Right, بِهَا حَرْفَ مَدٍّ. And so of course, the إشْمَام and the روم do not occur when you've converted the Hamza to a حَرْف مَد. So when you've converted the Hamza into a حَرْف مَدٍ, meaning a مَد letter, right, then in this case, we say that you don't apply إشْمَام or روم. You don't apply إشْمَام or روم. And the classic example is given is تَفْتَأ. Right, تَفْتَأ, it's a Hamza that has been written in the Mus'haf with a waw. طيب. And so here we have how many أوجه. We have the first wajah, remember, which is tafta, the hamza is sakina, right? Sakina arif, being preceded by tafta, being preceded by ta maftuha, and so we have of course ibdaluha alifan tafta, طيب حال الوقف. We then have of course wajhu tasili bil rom as well, wajhu tasili bil rom as well, right? Because sukun arif, and so we can say what taftahu, taftahu, طيب. And then we have of course ala madhhab al rasm, because we have here as we know a wow, the hamza has been written as a wow in the Rasm al-Uthmani, and so we have here of course the awjuh of al-madhab al-rasmi in what, in terms of ibdaluha wawan. Of course the wow here can be what, wow sakina, it can be wow sakina sukunan mahdha, and so it becomes what, taftau, taftau, طيب. And then of course because the taftau, the hamza in shahada dhamma, we can apply wajhu al-ishmam and wajhu al-rom as well. And so when it comes to إشمام and روم, it only occurs as the author mentioned, وَأَشْمِمْ وَرُمْ فِي مَا سِوَى مُتَبَدِّنٍ بِهَا حَرَفَ مَدِّنٍ وَعْرِفِ الْبَابَ مَحْفِلًا. Right, and so the إشمام and روم only occur when you are converting it to anything other than a harf mad. And of course, the waw in this case is not a harf mad, it's a harf lean. طيب, and so we can apply when it comes to tafta, we can apply ishmam and rawm ala al madhhab al rasmi. طيب, and of course, ala madhhab al qiyasi, when we say tafta, there won't be any ishmam or rawm. Why? Because you converted it to a harf mad. So when you converted it to a harf mad tafta, there's no ishmam or rawm. When you convert it to a waw taftaw, you can have ishmam and rawm. طيب, هذا والله أعلم. I think with that we have completed the mabahith pertaining to al ishmam, waqf hamza wa hisham ala al hams. فنقف عند هذا الحد والله تعالى أعلم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت, أستغفرك وأتوب إليك, والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.